Ah, I could hear your footsteps. Welcome back.
So, tell me what you know about the statue of Zeus.
Its great bone stood ready to punish the Kephallonians below. Or so I was told.
I've seen Kephallonia from the statue of Zeus.
Tell me, is it still a place of great beauty?
Its people are the happiest in all the Greek world. They sing and dance into the night with full bellies and full hearts.
But isn't how it was described to me at all? The tales go that its lands are among the world's most beautiful, and its people among the most pitiful.
Okay, I've told you what I remember. Now tell me about yourself. What's a Persian doing here?
Persia and the Greek world are doomed to be opposites. In times of prosperity here, Persians always seem to suffer. And when you're at war with yourselves...
Persians know peace?
Indeed. My people prospered after King Xerxes was murdered. All except for me. A man tried to kill me with poison, which is how I lost my sight. I fled and arrived here.
So there's a price on your head. Now I'm interested.
There was, though there isn't anymore. Now then, tell me another tale, and I'll tell you more of my past.
There are many statues to Athena. Which one do you mean?
In my mind, there is only one. Her story always began. As we rounded the hilltops, we could see Athens bustling below us, and Athena above, matching our gaze.
You'll be glad to know, I've been to the statue of Athena at the Acropolis.
Ah, if only I could have been there to feel her presence. Would you describe her to me?
If Athens is a city of statues, then Athena is their guardian. She stands high above everything, on guard over the city.
Yes. Not just standing tall to protect Athens, but to serve as a reminder of the suffering those poor people endured during the invasion.
Your turn to tell me something. You said a man tried to kill you.
The man who rose up to kill the tyrant Xerxes was named Darius. He was of a new creed of killers, unlike any Persia had known. He was also the man hired to kill me.
A killer of kings? Hired to kill a simple blind man? Why?
I have your interest, do I? Tell another tale, and I will too.
The Acrocorinth? Don't tell me. It's in Corinthia.
Smart guess. It is the most renowned temple to Aphrodite, your goddess of all life's most pleasurable trivialities.
I've traveled to the Acrocorinth. From there, I could see all of Corinthia.
Ah, I can only wonder at what the worshippers of Aphrodite do to pay her tribute.
It's quiet, mostly. People praying, offering sacrifice. You know, typical sanctuary stuff.
A temple to Aphrodite? Quiet? Impossible. Have you ever been to the temple?
Now that's out of the way. You owe me a tale. You said the king killer Darius was hired to kill you, too.
He was. By my brother.
Your brother? None of this is making any sense, old man.
I trust you. So I will tell you. My brother and I are the last living sons of King Xerxes.
Impossible. That would make you a king.
I was. My name was Artaxerxes. I guided Persia through a time of peace. But my brother wanted the throne and plotted my death. Now, I hide here, exiled, living the life of a simple beggar. I will tell you more, but first...
Yes, yes. A tale for a tale. You did say Mount Taietos, didn't you?
You sound like you know that place. I have heard tales of its appetites. They say the mountain feeds on the suffering of Spartans, so the people there offer their own children to the mountain god for sacrifice.
That's not exactly right. What do you remember about this armored bird in Arcadia?
There's a beast made of armor jutting out from the mountainside, overlooking Lake Stymphalos and the undulating fields, stretching like waves on a golden sea all across Arcadia.
I'll be back with stories to tell.
As soon as you've seen one location, please return.